arrangement as given. Now they are asking net field per day origin. All our passive charges are being asked in this direction. So all are in the same direction, add all depth, add all fields. Then field is 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught q by d square plus 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught 4 q by 2d whole square plus 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught 9 q by 3d square and up to last of 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught 100 q by 10d square. Now if you take it common, 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught q by d square, if you take it common, 1 plus 4 by 2 square 4 cancel, 1 plus 9 3 square cancel, 1 plus up to 10. So total how many terms are there? 10 terms. So this we can write 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught q by d square into 10. Now so the option is 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught 10 q by d square. Option 2 is correct. Now come to 12th question. A proton and alpha particle are placed in a uniform electric field. The ratio of their velocities after traveling in equal distance is. Proton and alpha particle are placed in a uniform electric field. So come to 12th question. Let us say proton. This proton charge, you take it Q, mass as M. Now alpha particle. Alpha means this is ionized helium. Remember this point. Alpha particle means ionized helium, means there is no electrons in the alpha particle, only protons are there. So then alpha charge, let us say 2q and mass is 4m. Clear? Alpha is ionized helium. Remember this point. Now what it asks? The ratio of velocities after traveling a equal distance. Then if we release these two charged particles in an electric field, they experience force, and due to that force they accelerate. Already I have given in the previous classes acceleration formula, our force is equal to Eq and A is equal to Eq by M. Clear? Now this is acceleration produced by electric field. And they are asking final velocities ratio. So initial velocity they release, initial velocity 0, then final velocity we can write this using this equation. Initial velocity 0, then final velocity we can write v square is equal to 2as. Displacement s is same in the both the cases, right? So this I can write velocity of proton squared by velocity of alpha squared is equal to 2 into acceleration in proton, displacement is remained same, 2 into acceleration in alpha, displacement is s, s s cancel, 2 2 cancel. Then this will be vp by v alpha is equal to root of ap by a alpha, right? Ap by a alpha. But acceleration equation is eq by m. So this we can write like this, under root E acceleration of proton, E charge of proton QP by mass of proton, total by E charge of alpha by mass of alpha. They released in same electric field, this will be cancelled. Now this is equal to under root of m alpha goes up, charge particle remains same by mass of proton, charge of alpha. Now substitute the values. Mass of the alpha particle 4m, charge of the proton q by mass of the proton m, charge of the alpha 2q. MF cancel, QQ cancel, 2 1s, 2 times. Now the answer is root 2 or root of 2 by 1. This is root 2 is 2, 1. Now the option is 2. Second option is correct.